and welcome to my channel. Today, now that all the like heavy makeup and glam stuff of New Year's is, well, New Year's and the entire month of December with Christmas and all, and, you know, the whole month of December of the holiday season is done. That was a very, there was a way too long explanation for a simple thing. Point is, yeah, I just really felt like doing something more basic this month, or this month, this week, this day, particular day. I'm bad at explaining things. Point is, today I wanted to do something quite more basic, something more back to, you know, the stuff that I learned back in makeup school that really upped my makeup game. And I wanted to share it with you guys. So basically I'm going to show you how to contour. I know a lot of people are struggling with that. A lot of people who start with makeup just really feel like it's quite a difficult thing to do. And I hope that my tips and tricks and just me showing you how I do it can help you. So yeah, basically what I feel with contouring, especially if you do a full face or foundation, your face can end up looking very flat if you're not careful, because, you know, like, the foundation just takes away all the nuances, I don't know if that's a word in English, but like all the slight color differences in your skin, and it takes away some of the shadows as well. So your skin, your face can look quite flat if you're just wearing foundation, especially with full coverage. I feel like a contour just brings back a shape in your face and brings back some life in the skin as well. But yeah, this is my opinion. Of course, there's nothing wrong with wearing foundation without contouring. Like, it's all up to you, yourself, and how you want your makeup to look. However, I just thought it'd be useful to show you how I contour. So basically, I'm going to show you it two ways. I'm going to show you in cream contour and I'm going to show you in powder contour. Which means that currently I'm wearing a double contour, so I'm very contoured right now. But yeah, without further ado, let's get started. Usually I would start with my eyes first and then do my foundation base and then contour with either powder or... not really, always powder actually. Just because it's more forgiving, it's easier to build up. With powder, you can just grab a little bit of powder and just start and then grab some more and make it darker, rather than with a cream contour where you're pretty much immediately going in with quite a deep color and then you gotta blend it out. So for a beginner, I would recommend to just, you know, use a powder. Even me as a pro, I still actually prefer powder to contour. However, for the sake of this tutorial, I am going to use a cream contour stick just because it will be a lot easier for you to see what I'm doing with, like, where I'm putting the shadows. And concealer for where I'm putting the light parts, just because, you know, powder is quite subtle, so it will be more difficult for you to see what I'm doing. So yeah, I'm using a cream contour, but if you're actually just starting out with contour, I would advise to do your entire base first and then contour with powder. First of all, we're going to do a cheek contour. I'm going to show you on this side, obviously. Assuming we're going for the, like, oval face shape that most of us usually tend to go for, if you have a long face, it's better to put your contour more straight towards the center of your face. If you have a rounder face by nature, you can always put it more to the more downwards, which will elongate your face. Me personally, I usually try to do it more like straight towards my nose because I already have quite a long, thin face. And if I make that even more prominent by putting it downwards, I'm going to look like this, which really isn't usually what I'm going for. Alternatively, if you don't feel secure guessing your face shape, you can always just feel where the bone is and follow that line. That's usually the safe way to go because it will at least look natural. And then just start at your ear, work your way forward, not too far, and just blend it out. Try to make sure that the darkest part obviously is near your ear and try to blend it out upwards, not downwards. Because you want the shadow to fall like this and, you know, not like that. Because you don't want this part to look thicker. Because that would look sort of random. But yeah, and again with powder it will look more natural than this. Like this looks quite sharp immediately. Which is fine as well, just depends on what you're going for. But for the sake of this tutorial, obviously I do want it to be very visible. Then for the forehead, I don't usually do a lot on it because I have bangs. But I usually go like this on both sides. Stripe here and then just blend it. By the way, another thing I wanted to mention, we all know the Instagram pictures of people with like their complete face in lines and then they blend it out and it looks beautiful. You may be able to do that with some cream contours, you'll be able to do that with powder because powder obviously doesn't dry. Don't do that with a with most stick contours, because for this one, for example, it's beautiful, but if I paint it on and leave it on for a couple of minutes, then it's just there to stay, and it's just... I'm going to have stripes on my face the entire day then. So, yeah, just to be safe, blend it out immediately. What I like to do is also put a dot here up my bottom lip and then blend it out. And this is just going to make my bottom lip look more plump. But that's optional, of course. And for the jawline, I'm keeping it light as usually because I don't want a stripe there. But I just do it like this and blend it out. And with this, I like to keep it light just because I don't want to have like a outline there, like I'm a cartoon figure. And also just as with the cheekbone contour, I have a stray eyelash there. Anyway, blend it downwards. And yes, it sounds weird if you talk like this. But yeah, blending it downwards will just complete the optical illusion. Illusion. I'm having way too much fun here. Another thing is to contour your neck. Just flex your bones a little so you can see where you're supposed to put it. I just blend this out randomly. The only thing I'm mindful of personally is that I don't go over my piercing too roughly. But yeah, this is just to make supposed to make it more hollow. The parts where I put the contour. Also, I always feel like if you do your entire face with contour and then forget about your neck, then I don't know. Like, this looks so complete then, and this just looks bare. So I just try to, like, you know, make it play along with the game. Then for the nose contour, this really depends on what sort of nose you want. And partly what sort of nose you already have. I always go for a straight nose, so I like it personally if this part is nice and deep and strong. And then I just also go for the tip of the nose to make it like more, just more straight and thin. You can also go for button nose, in which case you'll put a line here and blend it out towards the front. Which creates more of a sort of a Marilyn Monroe-esque nose. This really depends on what you want. There's heaps of videos on YouTube about people, or of people, I mean, doing full nose contours in different ways and shapes. So just, you know, go for whatever you like best. One important advice is use a smaller brush, because if you're going to use a big brush, you're just going to have a full brown nose, and that's really not really doing anything. Nose contour, I always blend downwards and not towards the bridge of the nose. And for the next part, I'm going to do some highlighting. If you're going to do a full foundation base first and then do the contour in powder, you're going to do this first after the foundation before setting it, obviously. But yeah, basically you see this as sort of a tutorial of where the light spots will need to be. I'm going to highlight beneath my eyes now. How heavily you do this, or light you do this, depending on how you want to look at it, just really depends on your own preferences. I know some YouTubers do it very, very bright. Others do it, you know, basically almost the same color as the rest of their face. It just really depends on what you feel looks good on you and what you prefer to wear. Because after all, you know, it's your makeup and you're supposed to feel comfortable in it. And you're supposed to feel pretty in it, or fierce in it, or however you want to feel with your makeup on. But it just really depends on what you want. So, yeah, just, you know, there's no right and wrong as far as that's concerned. I'm also applying this to the bridge of my nose and my forehead. Using a smaller brush, yes, I've also applied it to my chin, but I'm using a smaller brush just because it gives me a bit more control. And now I'm just powdering real quick before everything starts to crease. Just for completionist's sake, I'm not even sure if that's an official word. Anyway, I'm also going to do contour with powder just to show you how that's done. So let's just pretend I haven't contoured yet. Let's just pretend this is a full face of only foundation. Doesn't look like it, but anyway, just let's just pretend this is only foundation and powder. I'm going to do a contour with powder now. You can use different types of brushes for this. You can use a huge fan brush like this one. You can use a flat brush like this one, or if you're a complete beginner and really want to take it easy, you could use the tip of a sort of round fluffy brush like this, and just put a stripe there and then blend it out immediately, lightly, with a little bit of powder. That's the safest route. I do want to show you what I'm doing exactly, so I'm going to use this brush. And just as with the contour in cream, I'm just putting the powder in a stripe here. Trying to use as much as I used on the other side, so I actually get it even. You could blend it out if you're using a brush like this, very carefully dabbing. However, I prefer to use a fluffy brush for it, just because it's quicker. And this brush, because it's very dense, it has a tendency to move the foundation around underneath it if you're not careful. I'm not actually wearing foundation, but still. Better safe than sorry, so I just use this one instead. Again, just blending upwards, of course. On my forehead, I don't want a heavy contour, so I'm just immediately going in with a fluffy brush. Why do I feel like calling brushes blushes all the time? I don't know. Anyway, that's just what I'm doing here. Jawline, same story. And also my neck. Then for underneath my chin, I'm using a smaller brush. That's beneath my lip, not my chin, but anyway. My nose I'm going to do very lightly because I don't want to over contour it, but again, just doing the same thing as with the cream, just putting it there and blending it out. What I just did with the concealer earlier, you could do that with white-ish powder, very pale powder as well, but it just depends on your skin tone whether or not you're going to like that. Me personally, I would have to use straight up white and I would look very, very pale and rather unhealthy. So I'm just going to skip the step and move right along to blush. For highlighter, you can do whatever you please. I'm using one and I'm putting it still like right about here. I don't want to pull it up to my cheek because I think on me personally, it just doesn't look all that flattering. What I do like to do is put it in like sort of a C-shape, or on the other side of the face, a reverse C-shape. Of course, this way of highlighting is less natural than the concealer way, so I really use this to just bring things really far to the front. Just to make it all complete, I'm also going to show you a simple eye look. I'm just starting out with a primer to make everything nice and smooth there. I'm going to do on my eyes is basically a form of eye contouring. What I want is sort of a cat eye shape without, I don't know, without it being too much over the top. A lot of work. That was awful grammar. So basically what I'm doing is making a very fat wing in a brown shade, like so. Then I'm using a paler nude shade to, paler brownish taupe-ish shade. You know, just a very, a taupe shade, point is. I'm just using it to blend out the dark color all across, also on the eyelid, but also in the crease. And just making the entire crease deepen up a bit. I'm also blending out the outer edge a little, just not too far, because I don't want this to be like all smoky. I do still want definition to be there, I just don't want it to be as harsh as it originally was. You can just keep adding color and create a shape in the crease that you feel is flattering for your eye shape. Me personally, I always try to make it a little bit round, because otherwise I feel like it just gets, I don't know, sort of like hooded eyes without me actually having hooded eyes. Like, that's not the kind of illusion I want to create. So yeah, not that there's anything wrong with hooded eyes, but personally I just like the open eye look, so that's what I tend to go for. But it's just really a matter of trying it out on yourself, practicing, and just trying to figure out what you feel looks best on you. I'm also bring the taupe shade a little bit beneath my eye. Till about half. I'm going to go over it with a fluffy blender, just a clean fluffy blender in the crease. To make sure everything is nice and smooth. Then I'm putting a wash of a pale shimmery shade on the eyelid. Just to finish it off. Then some mascara, you could add a, well, you could use an eyelash curler first. Personally, I usually don't because I'm kind of lazy. I'm going to do my eyebrows off camera in a moment. So yeah, I'm just going to show you my lips real quick with a nude pencil first. And I'm going to use a nude gloss over top of that at the center. Just gonna make your lips look fuller. Okay, so here we have it, the final result. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my makeup tutorials, you can also subscribe to my channel. I also do nail art and jelly videos and whatever else I can think of. Also, I want to start doing more Get Ready With Me's again, just because I feel like, I don't know. I hadn't done those in ages and then I did one last week and I really enjoyed filming it so much. I really want to do more of those, but yeah, for now at least, I really hope this particular video was useful to you. I really tried to like make it as in-depth as possible. I gotta admit, most of the time, I really prefer to do full glam look and like elaborate eye looks, but I always feel like if I do an elaborate eye look, you know, I want to go in-depth about that and I want to show you how to do that. And if I then would also go in-depth about the basics like contouring, then the entire video will be like 5 hours long. Also, I don't know which of my videos is the first video you're watching, so if I were to like do that every single time, like if I were to show every single step of my makeup, every single tutorial, then for people who watch all of my videos, by the way, if you do, thank you very much. But yeah, that would just get very repetitive, I feel. So yeah, it just seemed more useful to just do a separate video on contouring. So yeah, basically, if you have any other questions about makeup or just want to chat, you can always do so in the comment section below. In the video description, you can find a list of all the products I've used as usual. You don't need to use all the stuff I use, of course. But if you saw me using something, or if you think, hey, that's really something I would love, you can find the full name and color code down there. Other than that, you can also find my social media accounts and names down there. I'm mostly active on Instagram with a lot of makeup. So yeah, I'd really love it if you want to follow me there as well. And that was it for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you'll have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!